Hi, I'm Xilong Chen, a senior manager at SAS and the head of Econometrics and the Time Series Group. In this video, I'd like to give you an overview of SAS Econometrics and SAS ETS software and to present a few examples of how these products make your modeling and analysis easier. SAS Econometrics and SAS ETS have been widely used in business, government, and academia. They consist of 51 procedures, 3 packages, 12 data engines, and 12 action sets. SAS Econometrics is in SAS VIA, which means it can take advantage of distributed computing. You can access all of its action sets through Python, R, Lua, and other programming languages. In this video, I introduce SAS Econometrics and SAS ETS in 3 categories: econometric modeling, time series analysis, and data interface engines. There are 27 procedures and 8 action sets that you can use for econometric modeling. You can model many types of data, such as category, sensor, count, cross-sectional, panel, spatial, and so on. You can also model compound distribution, dependency between distributions, and economic capital. Any of these topics is a huge area. In this video, I focus on 2 of them: economic capital modeling and spatial econometric modeling. A company might have many business lines or risk categories. Each business line might experience some losses. The company has to hold some capital as a buffer. But how much capital should it hold? If it holds too little, it might have a high risk of bankruptcy. But if it holds too much, it might miss important business opportunities. To determine how much capital to hold, it's critical to correctly model the distribution of the total loss, which is the sum of losses from all business lines or risk categories. It's a difficult task, but SAS Econometrics has a series of tools to help you do it. This flowchart shows one possible process of modeling economic capital. First, for each business line, you use PROC CNT select to model loss frequency and PROC civil select to model loss magnitude. Second, you use PROC CCDM to model the aggregate losses of each business line by integrating models that are created by PROC CNT select and PROC civil select. PROC CCDM needs scenario data when the count or severity model uses regressors. While you are building models for each business line, you can use PROC CCOPULA to model the loss dependency structure of the losses across all business lines and simulate a joint probability sample from the best fitting copula. Finally, PROC ECM combines CDM samples and the copula simulations and estimates the distribution of the total loss. Now, let's shift gear and look at our second example, spatial econometric modeling. When you buy a house, your real estate agent might tell you the 3 most important factors that determine the house price: location, location, and location. If you ignore the linkage between locations in your model might lead you to the wrong interpretation, the wrong prediction, and then the wrong decision. How does one location affect other locations? It might be through target variable y, or regressors x, or error epsilon, or a combination of all these factors. Here are 12 popular spatial regression models, and SAS supports all of them. In some cases, you need to solve a problem that involves many locations. In this example, there are about 65,000 locations. As you might know, this means that in one step of the parameter estimation, you need to find the inverse of a 65,000 by 65,000 matrix, which might take about 80 hours. If that step has to be repeated 100 times, that means 8,000 hours. That's 11 months. Impossible mission. But don't worry, Our procedure supports some fast and reliable approximation algorithms. How fast? It takes only 1 minute to solve this 65,000 location problem. How reliable? Here are the image of the true values versus their predictions. Can you tell the differences? Okay, we've talked about space. Now let's talk about time. A common question is, with all time series data in hand, could you understand the past well, have an accurate forecast of the future, and then make the correct decision at the present moment? Here are 24 procedures, 3 packages, and 4 action sets to help you. They cover almost all popular time series models, such as ARIMA, VARMA, GARCH, hidden Markov, state space error correction, and so on. I will focus on 2 of them, the HMM and the VARMAX models. HMM stands for hidden Markov model. It's one of the most popular machine learning tools for time series analysis, and it has been used in economics, finance, science, and engineering for 60 years. A hidden Markov model contains 2 chains. One chain is what you can observe, like stock prices and returns. The other chain is what you cannot observe, the so-called hidden states, like market states, bull, bear, or in between. The hidden states form a Markov chain. The chain of observables and the Markov chain of hidden states are linked through some conditional distributions. After you estimate the HMM, the hidden states can be decoded so that it seems you can directly observe those hidden states. As you see in this graph, the market states become observable. You can also forecast those market states and then devise trading strategies based on those forecasts. In the early video, I showed you how to devise trading strategies based on the hidden Markov model's forecast in order to beat the market and get a 70% better return or a 70% increase in the Sharpe ratio. Here, I show you how to use the model's forecast to beat the market even more successful, getting a 120% better return or a 120% increase in the Sharpe ratio. The second example for time series uses PROC VARMAX. The explanation or forecasting of one time series might depend on other time series. That's why simultaneously modeling multiple time series is very critical. PROC VARMAX supports a lot of popular multivariate models, such as VAR, VAC, GARCH, and so on. These models are advocated by SIMS, Granger, and Engel, all Nobel Prize winners. Last but not least, let's talk about data engines. Almost all the famous data providers listed here offer a huge amount of data on their website. However, downloading and converting those data to SAS or CAS tables can be very tedious. But if you use a data engine, you might need to use only a few lines of code. Let's use the newest interface engine, SASEMOOD, as an example. The SASEMOOD engine lets you retrieve time series data from the Moody's Analytics Data Buffet website. The website provides comprehensive economic data and forecasts at the national and the subnational levels. It offers more than 280 million time series. To retrieve the data by using the SASEMOOD engine, you only need to provide some common options like a working directory, username and password, and some specific options related to the data of interest, like the names of the data sets, time range, and output table name and format. Then you can access the data exactly the same way that you can use the data in a SAS or CAS table. Isn't that convenient? In the future, we'd like to support spatial temporal models, nonlinear non-Gaussian state space models, and a new data engine for accessing US BEA data. Please stay tuned. Thank you.